We put pressure continuously. Hi guys, welcome to Tactical Combat System channel. In today's video, I will show you some dry fire exercises combined with the application of the tourniquet on one arm. The most important thing that you must understand is that all the time you must upgrade your tactics and your training methods. It is not enough to train with fire weapons and with blades and becoming very good at it if you are not training also, for example, the tactical medicine part, the basic knowledge. In this case that today we are talking about, the application of the tourniquet. Take, for example, the next scenario. If you are in a real situation and you manage to protect the loved ones or civilians or your life by eliminating the target with your skills of shooting or blade fighting, but in this moment you or another civilian or loved one, it's hit, it's shot, it's cut, and he has a catastrophic bleeding, and you are not able, you don't have the basic knowledge to apply a tourniquet, and also you don't have this kind of tool with you, the situation is very bad. The majority of people that they are training in fire weapons or in blade combat, they are having the next mentality. They are thinking that if it will be an incident, a medical incident, for example a catastrophic bleeding, they will call the emergency medical unit and all the problems will be solved. In the situation of a catastrophic bleeding, the victim needs between 2 and 6 minutes to die. The majority of emergency systems respond, it's something between 5 and 7 minutes in cities, and they can go until 20 minutes in rural areas. So you don't want to have a member of your family, your child, your wife, or another civilian near you to see how it's losing the blood and is dying because you were thinking that the emergency units will be soon there and they will resolve the situation. So it's very important that you upgrade your knowledge, learn some basic catastrophic bleeding control in this situation, at least the tourniquet. Have it with you, this tool, in your backpack or in your pocket every day. And when the situation will come, you know how to use it and you can save lives with it. So I start now by showing you some simple exercises of dry firing. After, I will show you how you can apply the tourniquet, the KET tourniquet in this situation, the combat application tourniquet, on your arm. And then we combine the two in one drill that you can implement in your training. For this exercise, I am using again a replica, an airsoft replica, because I'm inside the house. Doesn't matter, it's a replica, like I said also before, treat it all the time like it's a real weapon. Don't put a finger on the trigger or inside the guard. Check all the time. In this situation, I don't have a magazine. Treat it like it's real. For making this kind of training at home, you don't require a lot of things. For the targets, for example, I am putting a small square of adhesive band, for example, different colors, blue or red, that I can focus my eyes on it. And I put it in the room, on the wall, at different kind of levels. The dry fire training is a very important aspect in your fire weapon training. Of course, there are some things that you cannot exercise with in a dry fire, for example, the recoil control and the precision when you shoot. I'm in a normal position with the hands at this level, or doesn't matter. One is going on the chest, the other is going on the gun. I deploy the gun, making the direction, the barrel in the direction of the target. I'm coming to the gun, meeting the both hands together, align my sights and be ready to shoot. When my sights are aligned on the target that I focus, then I push the trigger, coming out, coming back looking at the gun if I have a malfunction, reholster it. This position, catching the empty space and covering all the part of the handle of the gun and going with the thumb finger in the direction of the barrel. After I practice more and more, when I identify already the target and I know that that is a threat and it's a target and I'm already prepared to shoot, I will not align my sights, and when I am aligned on the sights, then I will go with the finger on the target and shoot, because this is timing plus. So I'm going on the gun, taking it out, and already my finger, because I know already, I identify that that is a trait that I must eliminate, already my finger is going on the trigger. So when already the sights are aligned with the sights are aligned on the target, then the only thing I must push the trigger. Shoot, check, put it back. This is the drill. Take the gun, meeting with the other hand, going on the target, focusing my sights, shoot, come back, check, put it in the gun. So only to reduce the time we are shooting, I align the sights, then I create muscle memory by checking for malfunction and then put it back. Why I check for malfunction? I was telling you also in my previous videos, because if I'm having the target shooting there on the target, yeah, I eliminate the target, I don't check my gun, but now in the other opposite direction is coming another target and I have in this moment a malfunction, I'm twisting to shoot again in the target, it will not shoot because I didn't identify the malfunction first to resolve it fast, so it will take less time than twisted to the target and being myself the one that is shot because I didn't check the malfunction and resolve it. And after your speed is increasing, you can make it more fast. So now the same drill, only that now we are moving, yeah. Very important, your training when you advance, to be with movement. Doesn't matter, blade fighting, fire weapons, hand-to-hand combat, you are moving, not remaining in the same place. Because if I am in this position, yeah, and already I have a threat, or identify a threat, this threat, for example, it's, if we talk about gunfight, he already deploy his weapon and take me, for example, like a target. If I am making this movement to deploy my weapon and remain on the same place until I deploy my weapon, he will shoot. So the chances that I will be hit, they are very high. So I'm doing the same movement, deploying my weapon, but moving my center from the line of fire. Of course, if you can move it more, you move it more. Here I'm exiting from the camera, yeah. So I'm here, I'm identifying the target, moving, shoot, verify. Simple drill that you can work. Shoot, verify. Shoot, verify. Then you can make the same exercises, the same drill, but changing your, for example, I am with a face at 12 o'clock for me now, and the target is coming from 3 o'clock. So I must change my position. So in normal situation, I will take my gun and shoot if my target is in front. But when you are in a real situation, you don't know from where the target is coming. So it will be the best part that the target is identified. You identify the target in front of you, but many times it's the other side, so it's more hard to identify the target, to twist, to move, and to shoot. It's the same concept. If I am remaining here and my target, I identify the target at 3 o'clock, and the target already take me he aligned his sights to shoot me, and I'm making the same deployment, moving my body towards the target, but remaining in the same place, is the same idea, because high chances that I will be shot. My reaction, it will be more slower than his action. So I make the same thing, but moving. Here I'm staying, normally you can walk and shoot, but this, when you advance the level. So I'm here, I'm making one step, already deploying the weapon, but I'm not staying in this position. Here, shoot, check. So from here, shoot, check. So guys, now we pass to the next level. In the idea that already you exercise and you can deploy your weapon in this simple drill that I showed you before. And now we put a jacket on us to carry our guns in a concealment mode. Because normally if you are a civilian, and also if you are a police officer or other law enforcement personnel, but you are not in the time of duty and you are in the civilian clothes, even if you have the gun with you, it will be concealed. You are not going with it on the street showing to everybody your gun. So I put the jacket. I remember from last time this trick, that is not my trick, I also learned it from others. When you have a jacket, to deploy your weapon, you must make this kind of movement, yeah? So if you have a soft jacket, a light jacket, this movement of the jacket, it will not go so fast. So I use basically to put, you can put a metal thing, some keys inside, that is making the pocket and the jacket more heavy. So when I'm making this movement, already the jacket is going very fast, permitting me to deploy my weapon. So in the same idea, I'm starting the same exercises, only that now I have the jacket. The weak hand is going up to the chest, the strong hand is liberating the jacket, yeah? And after he's making this movement, he's going already to the gun. So don't exaggerate it to give the hand to up, because this is empty space, dead space. I must come again with the hand to catch the gun. So it's only how much is needed until I am with the hand. I am with the hand at the level of the gun. So then I can deploy the gun. So one is going up. This is making the jacket, liberating the jacket. I'm going on the gun, extracting the gun, and I have the same process like before. So again, one up to the chest, waiting for the other hand. It's liberating, taking the gun, align the sights, shoot. Faster. The same with the other drills that I was showing you. When I master, or I am better with this first drill, I pass to the other one with the movement. So I have the same thing. I am moving and deploying the weapon. So I'm static, identify the threat for the beginning in front of me, then I move, I am deploying the weapon, check. The next step is that I show you again the tourniquet. I have a video in my channel, if you want to check it, it's about controlling the catastrophic bleeding, and I show there how to use the tourniquet. In that situation, it's on the leg. Today I will show you how to put it on the hand, especially when you are using the fire weapon or the blade, and one of your hand it's hit, so it's not functioning anymore, you cannot use it anymore, and a lot of blood is coming out, It's a catastrophical bleeding. So after I deploy the tourniquet, normally in the situation in which I am shot, I cannot use this hand anymore. So I catch it with my mouth, open it, put it on the hand, respecting the rule of high and tight, because being shot in the hand and having closer knee, it's possible that I cannot identify until I expose the wound to see where is the place of the wound. And I put it as high as I can. Then, now I'm using only to show you to see better how it is. And then on the drill we make it correctly. Yeah? We open this strap, put it up and tight, close it, coming under the hand, around, put it here, and now we begin to twist the stick of the tourniquet and close it at the end in this space that is special designed for closing the tourniquet. When the tourniquet is closed good, the blood must be controlled, the hemorrhage must be controlled. So now we can make the final drill in which we combine the dry fire with the application of the tourniquet. I have again the jacket, I carry my handgun in conceal mode, I have the tourniquet put it in the right pocket, lateral pocket of the trouser. You can start by simple positions. Normally when you are going on the street, you will choose where to carry your tourniquet, for example, in your bag, in your trouser. This is remaining at your decision. So I am in the normal stanza. Let's say that I am shot in the left arm for the beginning. I am using my right arm to make all the movements. So this is disappearing from the drill. I am deploying the weapon, align my sight, shoot, check, reholster, take my tourniquet up, open it, put it on the hand, try to not move the hand like you don't have the possibility because you are shot. I put it as high as I can, try to wrap it around. Closing the wheel stick, put the strap on it, and if I have the possibility, check the time. Of course, in all this thing must be done after I eliminate the target, after I'm not anymore. So if I was shooting at the beginning, yeah, the target is moving and I'm losing blood, I'm not stopping in that time when the target is not eliminated or the danger is not anymore there to reholster my gun and make my tourniquet, because I will be dead for sure the second time. Yeah. So first I eliminate the target. When the threat, when the danger is not anymore present, then I make the application of the tourniquet. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this video. Don't forget, if you like the content, to subscribe to the channel. And the most important thing, upgrade your knowledge and your skills.